Hi, in this video, I want to show you how to install Windows 7. In this tutorial, I'm using VirtualBox to simulate installation, but the way of installation still same. Either you use VirtualBox or bare metal machine. Even Windows 7 is end of life, but still there is people using it or buy Windows 7 from old stock or friend. First, we create VirtualBox instance. If you install to bare metal machine, you can skip this step. In VirtualBox main window, click new, type your instance names, tutorial Windows 7, and select type to Microsoft Windows and version to Windows 7 64-bit. If you want to install 32-bit, you must select Windows 7 32-bit. And for memory size, I set to 1 gig. That's minimum memory required, and leave to default. Create a virtual hard disk now. Click create button here, and this virtual hard disk. Select your location. My location Windows 10 data. VM, you can choose any folder you want, and for size I set it to 30, usually 25 is enough, but I want to show you later how to create partition just for 5 gig, just for show you how to create a new partition on installation. Leave all setting to default. Click create button, and next select your Windows 7 instance. Click setting. For general, don't have any change. For system section, uncheck floppy and send it to bottom. For processor, set it to 2 core, 1 core is enough, but I want to set it to 2 core. And for display, set to max, enable 3D acceleration, and for storage select your ISO. For bare metal installation, this will be DVD drive. And next, audio leave to default, network to default, and click OK here. And in bare metal installation, make sure you have set your first boot to DVD drive from BIOS. And sorry, I can't create video there because it very variative, depend on your motherboard, but usually to enter BIOS you can press either F1, F2, F11, F12 or Del key during startup machine, or you can press F8 to select boot priority directly if your motherboard have that menu. Once you have set your boot to DVD and have insert your DVD installer. Then message press any key to boot from CD or DVD will show. When that message show, press any key to enter installation windows. And for VirtualBox here, because I just first installation, that message will not show. And if you install for second time, it will show that message, press any key to boot or something like that. And click change here you can change your installation language and set time and currency format, keyboard and input method. You can change your preference here, but I just leave it to default because my input keyboard is US and time current whatever. Click next button and click install now. Okay, starting. Okay, next select your Windows version. I just select Windows 7 Professional for this tutorial and for example, and click next button. Oh, if you select 32-bit when you create new, you must select either here as long x86 architecture, but I choose 64-bit, so I choose Windows 7 Professional x64. Click next. Accept. Don't accept. Yeah, I can install that. Custom. Select custom advanced upgrade. Don't ever try this. Custom advanced. And here, you will be asked to select drive to install, and here I suggest to create two partition, one for system and one for data. For system you can choose any size above 25 gig, but I recommend at least 200 gig, and partition data you can choose any size. Click drive option. Click new, select 25, okay, 25 gig 2, okay, click apply. Windows will ask you to create a party new partition. Just click OK because Windows need it here. System here. There you will install Windows, and here I will show you how to create partition data. Click unlocate space. Click new, select size you want, or leave it to default. Click apply and Windows cannot be installed to this show detail. At least 7 gig. Yeah, I know. And here and for partition data, click format. Okay. If you have data before, make sure you have backup it. Because this first installation and I don't have any data, just click OK. Okay, here format. Not necessary. Click next. After you finish create a partition, click next and don't forget to select where Windows will be installed. Location. Next, and now we wait for installation. Oh, I forget to mention, while installation is in progress, your computer or instance will be restarts few times, so you just wait and maybe grab some coffee or watch movie from your mobile phone to wait. Maybe this will take a long time, depend on your DVD drive or your ISO. And next we wait first. Okay, after few minutes installation is finished, and next you will be asked to some setting. Here you will be asked your username for login, and type your name. And if you want to change computer name, you can change here. And if you want to change it later, you can change from my computer. And for now, just leave it to default. Click next. Type your password. You can skip this, but I recommend you to type password. Test one two three. For password in, you can type anything you want to let's say ignite your memory about your password. Let me in to, and after you fill that form, click next. And product type, I just leave it to empty. If you have product K, maybe you can try type it here. But as my experience, this will not activate or validate your key, because your computer, my computer, will not connect to internet before I install network driver to sum it. To sum it, when you first install before network driver just let leave it next and for setting I will select as me later. You can choose recommend setting, but I prefer as me later, and I suggest to select this. Select your time zone and your time and click next. And for network, just select public network and wait for Windows setting. Okay, now Windows is finished setting your computer, and if you have a product key, you can activate now. Of course, after you install your network driver, and here click properties, scroll down and click change product key, and type your product key here and click next. After that, you will be wait to validate over internet, and after everything check, this message will be gone and will change to your product key. And okay, that's it. Now you have success install Windows 7. I hope this video help you to install Windows 7 on your computer. And click like button if this video helpful, or dislike button if not. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in next video.